touch me, think twice, cause you got a long way. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to my channel. As a relationship expert and therapist, I am always on the prowl for unexpected flirting hacks that actually work. Whether you're a guy who likes a girl who likes a girl who likes a guy, or any of those other combinations, flirting is one of the fastest ways to get someone to notice you and to let them know that you think they are dope. Without further ado, today's video is the top 20 teen flirting hacks that you need to try. And if you have any trusty flirting hacks, let me know what they are in the comments below. Disclaimer right now, guys, effective flirting is subtle and intriguing, so I am not a supporter of ever just throwing yourself at someone. Oh my god, I'm so sorry I bumped into you, but your pecs are so hard. No. Guys, these tips today are way more effective than that, and they're gonna make your crush be intrigued by you and want more, but not feel like they've already won you. If you guys are new to Ask Kimberly, don't forget to hit the big subscribe button down below. I am currently doing a huge 200,000 subscriber giveaway, so in order to be entered, all you have to do is be subscribed to Ask Kimberly here on YouTube and follow the instructions in the description of that video. So are you ready to become a flirt? Let's get right into the video. Hack number one is to tag them in a funny or hilarious post, whether it be on Instagram, on Twitter, or another form of social media. This lets them know that you are thinking of them and that they're in that group of people that you're engaged with at the moment, but it's also not so isolating that it centers them out, makes them feel awkward, or makes them feel like you're totally head over heels for them. This is guaranteed to make them laugh a little bit, especially if the post has like a flirtatious undertone, and it will definitely lead to further discussion. Flirting hack number two is to ask for help with something. Now obviously, you don't want to seem helpless, but it's okay to be a little bit vulnerable sometimes, and this one is super subtle. So for example, guys, when I was younger, I actually asked a cute guy on a plane to help me lift my suitcase into the baggage compartment. For the record, guys, I could totally lift it. It wasn't even that heavy. It was just a really awesome way to start up a conversation. You could also try this if you're at the grocery store and like you have a list, but you're not sure exactly what something is. I totally need shallots for my recipe. Is this a shallot? Flirting hack number three is to give them a knowing look. If something interesting is happening around you, do not let the opportunity to make contact pass you by. So if you're waiting in line somewhere and you see the person at the front like emptying their wallet like pennies onto the counter, look at your target and give them like a knowing smile and laugh. The shared experience of something funny that's just between the two of you sets the tone for further conversation. Number four is setting a time limit for your flirting. Now this one might seem a little bit weird, but if you immediately mention at the beginning of your conversation that you have to go in 5 minutes or a certain period of time, this immediately makes you seem more desirable, but also helps your target relax a little bit because they know that there's no pressure. Guys, it's so genius. Number five, when you're in that conversation, get out at the right time. If you feel like a conversation is reaching its peak, then it's almost certainly the time to get out of that conversation. Your goal is to leave that conversation on a high note and leave the other person wanting more and wondering what else you could have talked about. The last thing in the world you want to do is cover all possible topics because you have so much time, leaving you with nothing more to say. Ooh. Flirting hack number six is to compliment, but be careful not to overdo it because it could come on too strong. I personally think that the best way to compliment someone is to do it in a text message, actually after the fact. You look so cute in that romper today. Your new haircut looks really good on you. Number seven, if you're having trouble finding topics of conversation, just bring up someone that you know mutually and talk about them. Science shows that we're more likely to like someone if we feel like we have something in common with them, so your mutual friends is the best place to start. Number eight is to get the scoop. So ask your crush to tell you the story behind something that you notice. So whether that's a tattoo or like an article of clothing, getting them to open up about something that might be a little bit more personal shows that you're interested in learning more about them. Number nine is replying with something funny to one of their Snapchat stories. So whether that's like a funny emoticon or just like LMAO, sending this shows that you've enjoyed watching their story enough to comment something. Now guys, number 10 is really good. It's to send a subtly sexy snap. So what I mean by subtly sexy is that it's on the exact border between a purposely sexy picture and a picture that you didn't mean to be sexy. The goal of this one is for your crush to be wondering whether you meant to send them like a sexy pic or if this was just like something totally innocent. You can do this by showing like a tiny bit of skin, like a tiny, tiny bit, or having your hair just like a little bit messy, or even just laying down playfully in your bed. You could do any of these without needing to be sexy, right? Flirting hack number 11, guys, this one's super important. One thing that we are all guilty of is getting just a little bit weird around our crush. It's almost like we don't want to admit that we enjoy talking to them or that we're having a good time. We don't want to seem too happy because we don't want to weird them out. But guys, this almost never gets misread, so if you are genuinely happy to see someone, just smile, tell them that you enjoy talking to them, and seem excited to be there. It's not a crime, you guys. Next, if this is someone who you've never talked to before, it's really important that you say something right away. After an initial approach, anything more than like 2 or 3 seconds makes for a lot of awkwardness. So if you are gonna actually approach someone, make sure you say something right away, because waiting too long can definitely interrupt that flow. Flirting hack 13 is focus on friends. Taking the time to entertain and engage your crush's friends by telling jokes and stories shows them that they're not the sole person that you care about, and also demonstrates your social value. If your crush's friends see you as the most entertaining and amazing person in the world, what kinds of things do you think they're gonna tell your crush when you're not around? That's right, they're gonna be good things. Moving on, guys, to number 14 is to use your eyes. The eyes are the window to the soul, but they also totally help you flirt. When flirting with someone, you should be trying to draw their attention to your eyes. Looking the person right in the eye when you're chatting sends a very clear message. I'm not trying to get out of this conversation. I enjoy talking to you, and I might be attracted to you. Number 15 is batter up. Now, I personally love the classic move of the eye bat. I don't care if anyone thinks it's cheesy. I think it's super vulnerable. All you have to do, guys, is look down and flutter your eyelashes a couple times, like this. 16 is to appear friendly and as open as possible. According to science, guys, getting approached in public has almost nothing to do with your looks and almost everything to do with your demeanor and your attitude. So people who stand up straight, smile, and keep their posture open are a lot more likely to be seen as confident and attractive. Oh my gosh, I think that one's so cool. Number 17 is one of my favorite flirting moves, like ever. Girls and boys, it is the bend and snap. If you've been subscribed to Ask Kimberly Forever, you know this one. It's also included in the movie Legally Blonde. Now, while the bend and snap might seem like something that was invented for a movie and something that might even be cheesy, it's actually so, so sexy if you get it right. The next time you drop something, bend down really slowly to pick it up and then pop back up, arching the muscles of your back and flipping your hair. I feel like maybe one day we should do a video specifically and exclusively on the bend and snap, because then I can show you guys exactly how you should do it. Do you guys actually want that? Tell me in the comments below. Because guys, if you get this just right, it can make you seem so confident. Number 18 is to get your touch on. So this can start totally small. So even if you just shake someone's hand or give them a hug when you first see them, that's a form of touch, and it actually breaks the touch barrier for more touch to be used later. So I think touch should be used very lightly, like a subtle touch on the arm, the hair, or even the face. When you're just flirting, touch should never have like intensity. Like, you should never have your whole hand on someone's face or on their arm. Like, that's just too much. During flirting, it should always be light and super playful, because this actually stimulates nerve endings, which can actually totally turn a person on. Flirting hack number 19 is to ask your crush a personal question. You can ask them about their family, what they're most afraid of in the world, or even the most embarrassing thing that's ever happened to them. Inviting somebody to share something really intimate with you shows them that you're interested in deepening that relationship and that you don't just see them as like a casual acquaintance. Okay guys, number 20, we have made it to the end of our flirting hacks. I really hope you've loved them. Number 20 is to practice often. Flirting is so fun, and the more you do it, the better you get. You do not have to limit your flirting to just your crush. You can flirt with anyone. It could be the cute server at the restaurant. It could be the cute pizza delivery girl. I don't care. It could be the cute grocery store stock boy. It doesn't really matter, you guys, but practice makes perfect, just like with anything else in life. So if you guys use these tips, you can be a totally effective flirt, and most importantly, you can have fun with the experience of flirting. All right, you guys, if you love this video, give it a huge thumbs up. Come and follow me over on Snapchat and social media so you do not miss the next Q&A. And of course, guys, subscribe to Ask Kimberly here on YouTube for more weekly videos on relationships. Bye!